Hello students, welcome back again. Children, I thought that I should prepare a separate video for the administration to discuss about the administration of Alauddin Khilji and Muhammad Tughlaq. So let's start with it, dear children. Now we have learnt about the Delhi Sultans. Now among them, Alauddin Khilji and Muhammad Tughlaq are the important ones. Delhi was attacked twice in 1299, 1300 and 1302 and 1303. As a defensive measure, Alauddin Khilji raised a large standing army. Now, how was the administration carried on by Alauddin Khilji? When, in the reign of Alauddin Khilji, when the Delhi was attacked, and it was attacked twice, that is in 1299 and 1300 and 1302 to 1303, so what Alauddin Khilji did, as a defensive measure, he raised a huge standing army. Then what happened during Muhammad Tughlaq? A sultanate was attacked in the early reigns of Muhammad Tughlaq's reign. As soon as he became a sultan, his sultanate was attacked. Okay, the Mongol army was defeated. Who has attacked the Sultanate of Muhammad Tughlaq? Mongol army. And it was defeated. Muhammad Tughlaq was confident about the strength of his army. He was very much confident about the strength of his army and his resources to plan an attack on Transoxiana. Okay, he therefore raised a huge standing army. Now, understand it, dear children. Alauddin Khilji, he always had a defensive measure that I should protect my country, whereas Muhammad Tughlaq, he started thinking that how I can attack on my enemies. Okay, so these are attacking and defensive measures. Let's learn about them further. Okay, now Alauddin Khilji, what he did, he constructed a new garrison town named Siri for his soldiers. Now we have learned about the garrison towns in the last session, right? So garrison towns means what? Where we can find soldiers, which is guarded by the soldiers. So what Alauddin Khilji did? Alauddin Khilji constructed new garrison town and he named it as Siri, and it was only for soldiers. Now if they are having a huge army, there should also be a facilities for them, right? So Alauddin Khilji constructed a new town and it was named as Siri. Next, rather than constructing, now what Muhammad Tughlaq did, instead of constructing new garrison town, the oldest of the four cities of Delhi, that is Delhi Ikuna, was emptied and its residents and the soldiers garrisoned there. So what he did, he started emptying, his residents were sent, of the old city were sent to the Daulatabad in the south, and he started emptying the city and the soldiers were garrisoned in the city. So this was the difference. Alauddin Khilji constructed new town, whereas rather Tughlaq, what he did, Muhammad Tughlaq, he he emptied the city and the residents of that city were sent to the Daulatabad. Okay, and the soldiers were occupied that city. Okay. Next, what happened? The soldiers had to be fed. Now, if they are having soldiers, they have to be fed. They need food, water, right? The soldiers have to be fed. Now, what Alauddin Khilji did, we'll see. The soldiers had to be fed. This was done through the produce collected by the tax for lands between the Ganga and Yamuna. The tax was fixed up to 50% of the peasants' yield. Now, we have learnt about the taxes also, right? So, the soldiers, from where the food for the soldiers will come, it was collected from the tax between the Ganga and Yamuna, and 50% of the tax was being peasant yield was taken as a tax. So Ganga and Yamuna, there were huge lands over there and large amount of agriculture was there over there, so there was abundant amount of food was available in that area. Okay, so and Muhammad Tughlaq, what he did, produce from the same area was collected as a tax to feed the army. But to meet the expenses of maintaining such a large army, the soldiers, the Sultan levied additional taxes. This coincided with the famine in the area. Now what happened, Alauddin Khilji, he was a wise man. He thought properly that peasants should not be overburdened with the taxes. But what Muhammad Tughluq did? Muhammad Tughluq increased the number of the revenue. And what happened due to that famine? Famines means upasmar. Okay. So this was happened in that area. People were not having food to eat. Okay. So next, the soldiers had to be paid. Alauddin, now they not only need food, but they also need salary. So what happened? The soldiers had to be paid. Alauddin chose to pay his soldiers salaries in cash rather than iktas. Iktas means what? A land, right? We have learned that military commanders were given lands. So what Alauddin Khilji did, he gave the soldiers salaries in cash. Okay, they were not given lands. The soldiers would buy their supplies from the merchants in Delhi, and it was thus feared that the merchants would raise the prices. To stop this, Alauddin Khilji controlled the prices of the goods in Delhi. Prices were carefully surveyed by the officers, and the merchants who did not sell the prescribed rates were punished. What happened? The Alauddin Khilji, he paid the salary in cash. So it was also a problem that if the soldiers are getting a huge amount of cash, the merchants can also, the shopkeepers can raise the price because they were having money. So if they raise the price, then also they can buy. For that, Alauddin also said that if shopkeepers, they were given specific price, a certain material, food material or any other thing cannot be purchased at the or cannot be sold at a huge price. He had decided specific price for all the things, and if at all any merchant doesn't follow this rule, he was severely punished for that. So this way the law and order was maintained. What Muhammad Tughluq did? Muhammad Tughluq also paid his soldiers as cash. Muhammad Tughluq also paid soldiers his soldiers cash salaries, but instead of controlling prices, he used a token currency, somewhat like present day paper currency, but made out of cheap metals, not gold and silver. People in the 14th century did not trust these coins. They were very smart. They saved their gold and silver coins and paid all their taxes to the state with this token currency. This cheap currency could also be counterfeited easily. Now see how people were smart at that time. He started, he used token currency. Okay, so while paying tax to the Sultanate, people were very smart. They used to pay the coins of silver and gold. But when he started a token currency, that was a cheap metal, it was not silver and gold, people started paying that their revenue also in the form of this token currency. So this was affecting the revenue of the kingdom. Next, Alauddin administrative measures were quite successful. See, now up till now we have learned, what you find the difference? Alauddin Khilji's administration was good or Muhammad Tughluq's administration was good? Obviously Alauddin Khilji was a good administrator compared to Muhammad Tughluq. Alauddin's administrative measures were quite successful, and chroniclers praised his reign for his cheap prices and efficient supplies of good in the market. He successfully withstood the threat of Mongols' invasions. See how important this is. He was a very good administrator. He was a very good king, and he never why he was praised? Because in his kingdom, the goods, whatever goods people used to buy, it was at cheap rate, and he was also a successful invader. Means he also withstood, means he bravely fought against the Mongols. Okay. And what happened with Muhammad Tughluq's? Muhammad Tughluq's administrative measures were a failure. Muhammad Tughluq didn't success in the administrative measures. He was a failure. His campaign into Kashmir was a disaster. When he invaded Kashmir, it was a disaster. He then gave up his plan to invade Transoxiana and disbanded his large army. Meanwhile, his administrative measures created complications. The shifting of people to Daulatabad was resented. The raising of taxes and famine in Ganga Yamuna belt led to the widespread rebellion. And finally, the token currency had to be recalled. So these all problems Muhammad Tughluq has to face in his period. Okay. So in the list of Muhammad Tughluq's failure, we sometimes forget that for the first time in the history of the Sultanate, a Delhi Sultan planned a campaign to capture Mongol territory. Up till now, not a single Delhi Sultan had dared to capture a Mongol territory. Muhammad Tughluq was the first emperor or first Sultan to capture or to plan a campaign to capture a Mongol territory. Unlike Alauddin was a defensive, he just protected his kingdom, whereas Muhammad Tughluq planned to expand his kingdom. Okay, Muhammad Tughluq's measures were conceived as a part of military offensive against the Mughals. Now next, the Sultanate in 15th and 16th century. We have learnt about Alauddin Khilji and Muhammad Tughluq. So what happened after that? Let's see. Take a look at table 1 again. We have learnt, okay, in the last session we have learnt about table 1, different who were the rulers of Delhi. If you remember, Rajput dynasties, early Turkish rulers, Khilji dynasty, Tughluq dynasty, Sayyid dynasty, Lodi dynasty, these were the rulers, right? So take a look at the table 1 again. You will notice that after the Tughluqs, the Sayyid and the Lodi dynasties ruled from Delhi to Agra until 1526. By then, the Jaunpur, Bengal, Malwa, Gujarat, Rajasthan and the entire South India had independent rulers who established flourishing states and prosperous capitals. This was also the period which saw the emergence of new ruling groups like Afghans and Rajputs. As we have said, as I have told you dear children, that it was not easy to administer over a vast empire. So what happened, what was the result of this? The cities like Jaunpur, Bengal, Malwa, Gujarat, Rajasthan, entire South Indian, what happened? They had their own independent rulers. Okay, so they started establishing their own independent states and their prosperous capitals also. And because of this, there was the emergence of new ruling groups. And which were they? Afghans and Rajputs. Some of the states established in this period were small but powerful and extremely well administered. Sher Shah Sur, 1540 to 1545, started his career as a manager of small territory for his uncle in Bihar and eventually challenged and defeated the Mughal Emperor Humayun, 1530 to 1540. Now we are learning about Mughals. Okay, Humayun was a Mughal Emperor. So 1540 to 1550, 1555 to 1556, Sher Shah Suri captured Delhi and established his own dynasty. Sher Shah Suri defeated Humayun and he established his own dynasty. Okay, and he ruled Delhi up to 1540 to 1555. It introduced as an administration and borrowed elements from Alauddin Khilji and made them more efficient. Now what happened, Sher Shah Suri and Humayun, what happened? They learnt lot of how to administrate. Alauddin Khilji was a very good administrator. Yes, we have learnt it now. So these rulers, what they did, they started learning, they learnt what all good implementation of administration was done, and according to that they also implemented same efficient administrator, okay, administration in their own kingdom. Sher Shah's administration became the model followed by the great emperor Akbar when we consolidated the Mughal Empire. After that, Akbar, that is Jalaluddin Muhammad Akbar, he defeated Sher Shah Suri. Jalaluddin Muhammad Akbar was a son of Humayun. Okay, so he defeated Sher Shah Suri and he also followed the same model which was followed by the Sher Shah Suri. Okay, and then we will learn about the Mughal Empire in the next lesson. I hope dear children, you have enjoyed watching this video. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. Thank you.